Sitaram Goyal was one of the greatest historians of modern India, and yet very few know about him. That is because he took an onerous task upon himself, that of rewriting the history of India. Indian history taught in our schools and colleges is written from an anti-Hindu perspective. The Marxists who wrote India's history had an animus against Hindu culture and civilization. They painted the Hindu past of India with a black brush and whitewashed the record of Islam and Christianity. Shri Sitaram Goyal sought to correct this injustice. He believed that the greatest hurdle in the path of a Hindu resurgence was the wrong history taught to our children. The dream of Macaulay of creating a deracinated generation of Hindus was being actualized every day in our schools and universities. Not waiting for the government to do something, he instead rewrote the factual history of India without any ideological bias. In his quest, he wrote more than 25 books on some of the most fundamental aspects of Indian history. Sitaram Goyal had never been an unconcerned spectator. In his youth, he flirted briefly with communism, but eventually became a proud Hindu. After meeting Sri Ramaswarup, he founded the Voice of India Publications. Along with a dozen other great scholars, he created the greatest corpus in post-independence India about Indian history, culture, and civilization. He wrote the true history of the Islamic invasions of India without sugarcoating this fact or whitewashing that. He went deep into the question of why Muslims destroy Hindu temples and painstakingly drew up a list of Hindu temples destroyed by Islamic invaders based on archaeological and literary evidence. Along with many other scholars like Dr. Konrad Elst, he created the intellectual argument for the reclamation of Hindu places of worship that had been destroyed and built over by Islamic invaders. He analyzed the history of Hindu-Christian relations, telling the story of how thinkers and scholars had debated and defeated Christian missionaries. Not neglecting the dangerous side of Christianity, he wrote a scholarly history of how the Christian missionaries swindle poor Hindus for converting them to Christianity. His greatest contribution was the exposure of the real nature of Indian secularism, which is but another name for the state protection of Islamic fundamentalism and Christian conversion activities. In simple yet powerful English, he wrote how the language of public discourse in India is perverted by Marxists and how the very meaning of the words are corrupted. He was an avid commentator on Nehruvian politics and its impact on India. He told us how Nehru was a die-hard communist who used his position to create an anti-Hindu ecosystem in India, and how he whitewashed the criminal record of Islamic invaders in the books authored by him. Sitaram Goyal wrote voluminously on how India was still reeling from the ill effects of Nehruvian policies. Founding Voice of India Publications, he collected a generation of brilliant and brave scholars who wrote the correct history of India. For this, he had to undergo many hardships. He had no government or organizational support. He also faced the ire of the Congress government and the anti-Hindu state agencies when he published some hard-hitting works of Sri Ramaswarup and other authors. With no organizational support, threatened by a hostile state in the pre-internet era, he wrote, edited, printed, and published around 100 books from some of the greatest historians and commentators in independent India. Shri Sitaram Goyal woke up an entire generation of Hindus to the dangers that they were facing. He made us realize that Hindu society was under siege. He gave us the intellectual weapons to make a valiant defense of Hindu society. He also made us proud of our resilience and deep roots. More than 100 years ago, great sages like Swami Vivekananda and Sri Aurobindo Ghosh had kick-started the modern Hindu renaissance. This renaissance was interrupted during the fight for Indian independence. The contribution of Shri Sitaram Goyal was nothing short of rekindling the fire.